Let's bring in former Labor Minister, regular on this show, Graeme Richardson. Richo, you worried by that news poll today, the first one that has the coalition in front since the last election?
Well, you don't like to see it if you're in my shoes. But that having been said, it's a long way from the election, and it's not too unusual for governments to fall behind in the middle of a term.
Particularly when you've had a dozen rate rises that have happened on their watch, whether they've got some culpability or not, many say they spend too much, others think they have done the right thing with the cost of living relief that's been offered. But either way, Richo, it's tough when you've got rate rises and so many of them.
Yeah, government isn't easy, that's for sure. And, for Chalmers and Albanese, the range of choices now are limited. And so they've got to be very, very careful about each decision they make.
If you're in the advice group, in the strategy at the national headquarters, what's the plan from here in the final 6 months? What needs to be done for them to not just win minority, but possibly even give majority government a shake? Is it still possible?
Well, when you say it's still possible, I believe that's what will happen. I think that in the end, there'll be a majority government. I think that Albanese and Chalmers and Miles as a group are fairly attractive to people, certainly a lot more attractive than Dutton and Angus Taylor. So I think things are looking okay.
There have been some critiques from those that served in your era, the likes of Gareth Evans, Paul Keating and others, critical of some of the foreign policy components. Bill Kelty saying there's been not enough ambition. What do you think of some of the elder statesmen of the Labor movement and your political party with their free advice at the moment?
Yeah, well, sometimes that free advice would be better kept to themselves. That having been said, the gods of the party have a right to speak, and I don't think you can ever deny them that. So I expect it to happen, and I just hope and pray that when they do speak, they don't go too hard on us, because they rarely seem
when
to speak in favour of us.
Yeah. No, that's it's true, certainly lately. The Queensland election coming up, you're going to be on that panel along with Anastasia Palaszczuk and many of our other colleagues. Richo, suggestions today that Anastasia Palaszczuk might have given Labor a better chance had she stepped down earlier. I'm sure she'll want to reply when she joins us on election night to that. But it sounds like they're not giving Miles much of a chance a couple of weeks out.
That's probably because he's got Barclays. I don't think that Miles can win. I think Chris Afurley has had the advantage of being up on the stage with his name in lights for quite some time. And Chris Afurley's a very effective performer. I know him quite well. Yeah. And there's no doubt about it, mate. He's worth powder and shot. So I think that Labor's in for a very tough time in that election.
It's going to be a great election night with yourself and, of course, Peter Credlin, Clennell and Anastasia Palaszczuk, Campbell Newman. Big night. Looking forward
to it,
Richard.
Pretty good panel.
Thanks.